Hello everybody, I am Dubravka Djurić from Belgrade, Serbia. I am a poet and professor at Faculty of Media and Communication. I was invited by Henrique Stahl to rethink about poetry as a kind of exchange. We are here in three weeks staying at home in midst of a global pandemic of coronavirus. And I will now read you a very short text. It is my reaction to this kind invitation. And it summarizes my thinking about poetry in recent year and a half. And in this short essay, I want to consider some important poetic themes of contemporary poetry production. I am interested in the way that the field of poetry changes globally. I will discuss the notion of difficult poem and a hybrid poem, which are defined within the context of American poetry. And then I will continue to the notion of eco-poetics, but very brief. All this in order to rethink about my own poetry practice and its place within Serbian and post-Yugoslav production. The discussion of a difficult poem in American poetry takes place at the moment when poetry is going through important transformations. In his book, Attack of a Difficult Poem, from 2011, language poet Charles Benstein deals with the phenomenon, with this phenomenon, with humor, because difficult poems invoke anger and frustrations in some readers. The poetry of high modernism, a tradition that language poetry inherited in a unique way, demanded knowledge and effort. And difficult poems betray a reader's expectations because they are not comprehended as coherent lyrical icons. This kind of poetry rejects mainstream values, and it's usually non-narrative and not coherent. Bernstein writes, quotation marks, "They are not incoherent, meaningless, or hostile," end of question marks, and advises reader not to lead difficult poems, not to let difficult poems intimidate them, but instead approach them differently. In the introduction to the book, The Fate of Difficulty in Poetry of Our Time, from 2017, editors Charles Altieri and Nicholas D. Nice define difficult poems through their formal aspect as, quote, "a matter of how poets organize language of poetry," end of quote, in the broader sense, quote, "how contemporary poets deploy difficulty in their linguistic and lyrical structures." At the end of the 80s and beginning of 90s, the complex poetry of New York School from 50s became globally influential. I will point to the Slovenian and Polish O. Harris poets. After that moment, this movement spread its influence to other poetry cultures around the world. In Poland, then, we find a revival of interest for innovative poetry in so-called linguistic poetry, which I will connect to the global influence of language poetry, as well as the reactualization of similar paradigm from 60s and 70s, operative in various parts, various poetry in West and East Europe of the time. The influence of language poetry within American poetry could be seen in the phenomenon of American hybrid poem. This poetry absorbs some characteristic of innovative poetry, especially language poetry, mixing it with the lyrical impulse against which language poetry constituted itself. The dynamic fight within the global poetry field shows another contemporary tendency. Long poems, which function as versified narratives. This device can be seen as hybridization, which questions the generic characteristics of poetry and prose. At the same time, it can be said as it could be seen as the global synchronic tendency, inheriting and renovating more conventional approaches to writing, aiming at the absorption and questioning of innovative devices. In the broader cultural context, hybridity has been understood as globalization's imperative. It embraced all aspects of contemporary production, including poetry. In poetry, this includes the mixing of poetic devices with devices of other literary genres, as well as with textual of visual models ranging from the essay, theory, visual art, photography, etc. The dynamics of contemporary globalized poetry production is extremely rapid. Different patterns of generating poetry are activated, and the imperative of hybridity complicates the reception of the production because the combination of mixing endlessly increases. If we look at the availability of poetry for a critical consideration, we will take into account the fact that publishing houses are not interested in poetry, which makes it more difficult to have insight into the poetry scene. On the other hand, poetry is trendy thanks to the internet magazines for literature, reading, public readings, and numerous festivals in different parts of the world. In this democratized, but at the same time devalued field of culture, the question for a poet is in which direction to develop her own poetry production and avoid established patterns and the established canon, if that is possible. The moment is interesting insofar as innovative poetry practice are globally historized and absorbed in the mainstream. In mainstream contemporary poetry, non-narrative devices are combined with lyrical and narrative ones, and in the context in which innovative poetry is still present in the new millennia in different modes, the question is how to construct the genealogy of different poetry practices and point to different historical lines within a particular national corpus. At the same time, the question is how to construct the line in which your own poetry could fit. This is important because the mainstream critics deals with a contemporary canon, which consists of a fixed number of poets who in their poetry confirm and inscribed in the national poetics the values of the canon. Critics dealing with the mainstream national canon include certain poetry practices, or if they deal with atypical poets, their work is designed in such a manner to fit into the canon. When I consider self-historization and self-interpretation, I think of the Croatian artist poet Lado Martek, who discursively questions and defines his own poetry using always new theoretical frames offered by global theoretical trends. When considering my own poetry, I will point to the importance of poetry formation called AWIN School of Poetry, a group of then younger female poets working in the Feminist Association from Women's Initiative, AWIN, between 1996 and 2006, in which we worked together as a collective producing exciting poetry and poetics production, which is now forgotten. In regard to this, it occurs to me that I have to construct a possible history whose starting point would be the concept of Serbian, Croatian and Yugoslav art historian Ješa Denegri. His notion of other tradition, druga linija, from the 70s referred to the Yugoslav art practice that was produced in the then new media, photography, performance, installation, the book of artists, etc. The question is why this term was not applied to poetry at the time. The answer is that poetry is inseparable from the national languages of former Yugoslavia, so that poetry was delineated at a national basis. At the same time, within the different Yugoslav national poetry fields, the unique paradigm of innovative poetry didn't exist. In this respect, the conversation took place in the office of the student's magazine Index in Novi Sad in 70. Two members of the editorial board, Slobodan Tišma and Janez Kocijančić, at the time young poets, advocated the poetics of Slovenian innovative poetry called Reizam, with the poet Tomas Šalamun as the most distinguished among them. Reizam was part of the global linguistic turn in humanities and the arts of the time. To other participants in the conversation, Tito Bjelopavlović and Pero Zubac, established poets, were negative toward Reizam because they considered it not to be poetry at all. In Ažin School of Poetry, we directed our attention to innovative poetry. We read the poetics of innovative poets from the 28th century, using their work as the main reference for our poetry. Such innovative poetry ranged from futurism, zenitism, the new American poetry, especially of Black Mountain College, to language poetry, with special attention directed to particular Slovene, Serbian and Croatian poets like Šalamun, Tišma, Vladimir Kopicel, Nina Živančević, Jelena Lengold, Ivana Milankova, Jelena Marinkov, Jasna Manjulov, Josip Sever, Sanja Marčetić and Zorica Radaković. The poetry that we read was not separated from our own practice. We read it in order to gain knowledge about this, then marginalized practice in order to activate these poetry ideologies within the new historical moment in which we lived. If we look now at the current historical moment, we will see that the different poets who participate in various poetry streams deal with two main topics: the brutal neoliberal exploitations of workers and with ecology. The politics of poetry, as the language poets wrote of it in 70s, referred to language as a site of social engagement. Today, in the dramatic crisis of neoliberalism, culminating in this moment in the pandemic of COVID-19, the imperative of criticism of neoliberalism with the exploitation of human resources and resources of planet Earth is crucial. We will see what will be next when this global disaster comes to an end. And that is all. Bye-bye to everybody.